Good morning. Good afternoon, Alex. I was in the courtroom when Lorenzen's family walked in. Of course, Deborah Marion, the first person to walk in, she was wearing a red shirt, a red T-shirt, in his memory, along with her mother, Louise Vassar, his sister, lots of other family members and friends. They came in, sat in on that front row. Judge Coffey then called the court back out of recess. Court came to order, and Sherra Wright was escorted in. She was wearing that orange prison shirt, gray pants, and orange croc-like shoes, and that was when it all played out. She entered a plea, 30 years, two counts, counts 1 and 3, a facilitation count, as well as a conspiracy count, and up to a total of 30 years, plus another 8, but those were run concurrently, so basically 30 years, and she has eligibility to get parole after 9 years. So that was what played out in court today. And something else, probably the most interesting moment, is when Deborah Marion walked up to the stand. Judge Coffey said, "Miss Marion, I know you wanted to speak early on, and I didn't give you that opportunity because I asked you to wait." She waited patiently, and she had her moment today. She stood right up at that microphone, and she looked directly at Sherra, and she said to her, "I want to see my grandchildren." She even personally referenced one of the younger children, saying that, "I know she wants to come home to us and make chicken and dumplings. We want to be with our grandchildren." She said, "Lorenzen is gone, but he made me some beautiful grandchildren," and she thanked Sherra for those grandchildren. Sherra actually tried to respond. She asked Judge Coffey, "Can I respond to this?" Judge Coffey then turned to her attorneys and asked them, and they said no, so she didn't have the opportunity to respond. I asked Deborah Marion after that, had a chance just a little while ago to speak with her, why she wanted to direct that first question at her. And she said to me, "I know her. I wanted to speak directly with her." And this just all sort of gave you a sense, and I know many of you have been following this story because Lorenzen meant so much to this community, but this has torn their family apart. Deborah Marion says there are some of the children that she has not spoken to in years. Sherra and Lorenzen had a total of 7 children together. One of them died when she was just a baby. So a total of 6 children. The oldest ones are in their 20s. The youngest one's still young. And so many of the family members like Deborah, particularly on that side, saying they just want a chance to see them. But they also made it clear that they are going to continue to fight. They said they are glad that this day came, but making sure that his memory always stays alive is something that's very important to them. And I also want to let you know that Lorenzen Wright would be 43 years old right now. On Sunday will mark 9 years from the day that his body was found in that field in Southeast Shelby County. They just had a vigil for him last week. Deborah Marion saying she didn't want to do it this coming Sunday because she wanted to focus more on his life rather than his death. So this has been a long time coming, 9 years, of course. He disappeared last seen by family and friends on July 18th of 2010. 10 days later was when his body was found. His mom was the first to make the call and say, "Hey, my son is missing. Something is wrong." And from very on, as April has mentioned, there were some family members and friends that believed Sherra had a role in it. Now, there were a lot of details that they did not want to get into today, because understand, there is a co-defendant in this case, Billy Ray Turner. Billy Ray Turner was actually set to be sentenced in a separate case, a gun charge, tomorrow. That has been reset. So all of this, the attorney said, played out very quickly. But if you listen to other legal minds, they will tell you that this was part of the strategy. When it comes to co-defendant cases, making sure one may be willing to say something against the other. And Billy Ray Turner was staring at almost 20 to 30 something years just on that gun charge alone. So it'll be interesting to find out, if we ever find out, if he was going to say a lot about what possibly happened. They also talked a lot about an unindicted co-conspirator in this case, Jimmy Martin, who is Sherra's cousin. He is currently serving 20 years for second-degree murder of his girlfriend. That happened back in 2007, but he began cooperating with police in this case in 2012 and admitted to a lot of things. That came up in court today. ADA Paul Hagerman bringing that back up. That was read aloud in court, his role. He also talked about, basically, they had to explain what evidence they would have brought to trial if they were going to go to trial. And then they talked about the plea and brought Sherra up to the stand and read her her rights. She said very little. Judge Coffey wanted to, of course, legally they have to ask you, if you understand all of these things. She did. One of the few questions she asked was, he went down this list of things that you give up now that, you know, you've been convicted of this felony. And she said, is that the only right that I lost? And he said no, and continued to read. And then he asked her if there's anything else you'd like to say. And she said no, but she did ask a question. She said, will I get credit for time served? And then he asked her, how long have you served? Has it been 2 years? And she said, no, I haven't been in as long as Billy. He went first. Of course, he was arrested in November of 2017. She was arrested in December, a month later. She wanted to know if she was going to get credit for her time served. And he said yes. She exited the stand, and that was when Miss Marion came up to speak her piece. We spoke to several family members after court, including Deborah Marion, her pastor, his Uncle Lorenzo Searcy, one of his dear friends, Monte Nevels, and they all said they had been waiting on this day for a long time, just as many others in the community that Lorenzen meant so much to. Alex, I'm going to send it back over to you.